You're going on a journey. A journey through memory. All you have to do is follow my voice.
Reminiscence marks the feature film directorial debut of Westworld co-creator Lisa Joy. The movie has a relatively involved core premise. Set in a near-future version of Miami, after climate change has raised the water level, and in the wake of disastrous border wars, Reminiscence is built around a technology that allows subjects to relive their most treasured memories. Hugh Jackman plays Nick Bannister, a traumatized veteran with a small business managing this nostalgia. Nick strikes up a relationship with a client named May, played by Rebecca Ferguson. However, one day May disappears, and Nick finds himself trying to figure out where she's gone, and whether the relationship ever was what he believed it to be. There are simultaneous plots unfolding about futuristic drug dealers, corrupt land barons, and police investigations. Reminiscence is about a lot of things. In fact, it's about too many things. On a larger thematic level, it is a film about the dangers of nostalgia, about the gulf between rich and poor, about privacy, and about broken systems. On a more character-driven level, it is about addiction, about obsession, and about the question of the gap between the reality and the memory of a shattered love affair. The problem with Reminiscence is one of scope. In many ways, the movie feels like a television pilot. It seems to spend most of its runtime establishing the rules and contours of its world, but gets very little time to actually live in that space. To give the movie some credit, that world is interesting and compelling. These ideas are engaging. Joy, who serves as both writer and director, clearly enjoys playing with the tropes and conventions of classic film noir. The idea of subjectivity and ambiguity, the broken hero, and the lingering trauma. The movie is populated with little details that are fun and clever, such as the small observation that rising temperatures have effectively rendered mankind nocturnal, providing a narrative justification for the classic noir device of these characters wandering listlessly through the night. However, the finished film never gets to actually enjoy any of these individual elements because it is too busy bringing the audience up to speed on whatever the next big deal is supposed to be. Reminiscence often feels like a collection of scenes that are strung together, rather than anything actually living or organic. Its characters seem like cutouts and cliches, more like two-dimensional objects than real people. It doesn't help that Reminiscence itself is reminiscent of much better films operating at this intersection between science fiction and film noir, often serving as a counterexample that illustrates how hard it must have been to get those films to work. The movie very consciously evokes Christopher Nolan's Inception, with its recurring water and social decay imagery, its premise of military neural technology being repurposed for civilian use, and its lead character's implied addiction to that technology while being haunted by an old flame. However, this comparison only illustrates how much better Nolan's film is at weaving exposition into an engaging narrative. In its science fiction noir trappings, the film also recalls Blade Runner, although not that film's best self. Much of Reminiscence world-building is carried by heavy-handed expository voiceover from Hugh Jackman, recalling the labored exposition employed by Harrison Ford in the theatrical cut of Blade Runner. Jackman's monologuing stops the movie dead, continuously and repeatedly. The result of all this is frustrating. It's disappointing that a movie titled Reminiscence should be so entirely forgettable. Reminiscence is available in cinemas and on HBO Max from Friday, 20th August.